Hello, online pipe community. Ethan, Parsimonious Piper here. We have another episode today of YouTube Pipers Care. But first, in my Friday Savinelli, I am smoking a bowl of my secondhand bookshop mix. And it is hitting the spot. Well, I only have three items this week, but each of the three is a little weighty. Corvette Jim. Corvette Jim's doing well after his surgery. He's basically completely off the pain meds. And that's a wonderful thing. His mom was recently hospitalized. Spent her birthday, from what I understand, in the hospital. And has been diagnosed with PISA syndrome, something I was not familiar with, that basically affects one side of your body. Two of them could definitely use our support and prayer this week. Yusuf Syed, who is a non-presenter but a frequent commenter on videos, just this last week had part of his leg amputated. He is at home recuperating. You can't drop by his channel, really, to leave him a comment, but you can keep him in your prayers this week. Last, Kevin Twiner shared with us in a very touching video that his wife had a stroke this last week. But the effects have been pretty severe. Life is not returning to normal quickly, as one would hope. Definitely drop by his channel if you would. Leave him some support. Keep him in your prayers this week. That's one of those hard things to imagine. Now, I do have something personal to share. One of our European presenters, Prunk You, asked me last week. He said something to the effect of, you know, you're always sharing the problems that other people have, but what about yourself? How can we support you? Very kind and thoughtful. And it's true, I don't very often share issues in my own life. A lot of times we're not really comfortable doing that. It's not because my life is perfect. Boy, hardly, not even close. Let me share the current frustration that I've been dealing with for the last couple of months. An organization that I've been involved in for quite a while, not my employer, had a position come open right around Christmas, just after, in fact. And for the last few months, they've been kind of limping along with various people filling in. But no consistency, and it shows. So about a month ago, I wrote a letter to the head and personnel committee and let them know that I was very interested in filling the position. Detailed the fact that I am overqualified for it and have decades of experience directly relevant to it. And just this last week, they went outside the organization and brought somebody who is less qualified and has almost no experience to fill the position. quite a slap in the face. Now, I'm not going to abandon this organization because I believe in what they do in the bigger picture. But I am hurt by the fact that they obviously don't want me to do the one thing in the organization that I'm most qualified to do. And there are many people in the organization who know that I'm very qualified, and including people who've made this decision. I'm saddened, a bit hurt, confused as to why the organization would put somebody in this position from outside when they have somebody right here that would be perfectly willing to step in. This person does have connections to those who made the decision. So, you know, a lot of times it isn't who you are, it's who you know. What I would appreciate your prayers for my attitude. That, not to get too preachy, but that my attitude would be like that of Christ. Jesus showed his humanity in the garden before his crucifixion when he said, Father, look, if there's any way we can do this differently, let's do it. Not my will, but yours. They were told that though he had every right to claim his authority and identity as God, he did not. He humbled himself to the point of the cross. That's not going to happen to me here. I'm not going to be crucified. I am, however, going to have to humble myself and do whatever I'm allowed to do in this organization. So I would appreciate your prayers of support in that regard, that I don't become angry and bitter or indifferent. And that I just I do my job within the group and wait for God's timing. It's a hard thing to do. Now that may seem like a somber way to end the week, but it's really not. That's the worst thing that's happening in my life right now. And for that, I am thankful and oh so blessed. And with that, light something you like. Maybe blend it yourself and enjoy your weekend.